Sometimes your computer might feel a bit under the weather, a bit sick. It doesn't want to get out of bed, at least the right way. Sorry, that was a weird intro, because right now we're going to be talking about the system configuration utility. This will be a quick one. Let's check it out real quick. You will use it a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean every once in a while. Here in Windows, we're going to search for system config. There it is right there. Also, the short term. So just so you know, back in the day, before we had this amazing search bar, we had to type in run, the run app. This is the only way to do it. And then we would have just have to know the name of the application we wanted to run. So I would have to type in like msconfig.msc. No, that's not it. I think it's just msconfig maybe. Yeah, that's what it was. But the better way, and thank goodness for the search bar, is just typing in system config. Go ahead and launch that sucker. Now notice here in the first section, we have general. Our general settings, and it's mainly focused on and exclusively focused on startup selection. How your computer is going to boot up on the next boot. So by default, you want a normal startup. Load everything that you have installed on your computer, all the things Windows needs, all the things you need. That's when things are healthy. But then maybe you start getting the old blue screen of death. Your Windows computer starts acting weird. Something's not running right. That's when you want to become your computer's doctor. Start diagnosing, start troubleshooting. Okay, what's going on with you? Let's try and do a few things different to troubleshoot that. And that's what the diagnostic startup is for. It's going to load the basic devices and services only. Only the things that are required. And what that will tell you is, hey, is there something like catastrophically wrong with your system, or is it maybe something you added? Probably one of the best troubleshooting features on Windows, because normally it is something you added. And this confirms that the base operating system, the way your computer works, is doing great. It limits the amount of troubleshooting you have to do. And then of course, selective startup. You can choose to load system services, startup items. It's kind of a hybrid between the normal and diagnostic setup. You have more options. Now let's meander on over to the boot section. This is a fun section. So here we have, first of all, what are you gonna boot off of? Now you may not be aware that you can install more than one operating system on a disk. Take a hard drive, cut it in half, install Windows over here and Linux over here. It's called dual boot. In Mac, they call it boot camp. And if we had multiple OSs installed on this disk, you might see it here. And then just below that, we have the safe boot options. This is another way you can troubleshoot your system if it's acting kind of crazy. Now, safe boot is like your computer's really sick. It's acting crazy. Diagnostic mode didn't work or whatever. Safe mode or safe boot will boot your computer in the most minimal way possible. Just saying, can it even start? And you can even specify what you want to load. Let's select safe boot. I can say minimal, which does like almost nothing. You'll have the ability to run some repair utilities, try and fix your computer. You can also do network mode to where it'll actually have access to the internet. That's how safe it is. It's like, we're gonna boot you up, little buddy. But you can't do anything, you can't go outside, you can't get to the internet. That's what's happening there. And then you can do extra things like no GUI. Log that sucker, base video. Give me some OS boot information. I'm gonna uncheck all these, I don't want any of that. Now, what will additionally help you troubleshoot your boot up is the services tab. And it's not just for troubleshooting, it's for disabling services too. I click on that. Here we have all our enabled services. So in a previous video, we talked about task manager, and you can see the services that were on your system. You could start them, stop them, restart them. And here they are, the ones that are enabled. So if you're running into some issues, you can go in here and just like start disabling services and saying, huh, is it this guy? Is it this guy? Is it this guy? And just keep trying to do it. I can hide all the Microsoft services right here by clicking this checkbox. So I only see the ones I've added, which on this system I haven't added a ton. Because I could probably safely assume it's not Microsoft doing it to itself, it's probably me doing it to it. So I can start troubleshooting the things I've added to the computer. Now this is kind of funny, and this is a mistake I made. In a previous video, I talked about Task Manager. And I was like, you know what? I don't like managing startup in Task Manager. I like using it in another tool. This was that tool, and egg on my face, watch what happens when you click on this. To manage startup items. You're gonna wanna use Task Manager. If I would click on that, it's gonna open up Task Manager with the startup items. So that's where you manage your startup. And then finally, if we look at tools, this is kinda like a catalog of things we're gonna go through later that you'll find elsewhere. It's just a nice handy place to see it. So we have things like, hey, changing UAC settings. We've already talked about that, but it's a quick way to get there. Just launch it. It's like a little shortcut book, computer management. We can launch that and go straight to our users. And that is the system configuration tool. When your computer feels a little under the weather and you need to troubleshoot a few things. Definitely an admin tool. You won't see users jumping in there too much. That's all I got. I'll see you in the next episode.
Oh, you're still here? If you want to see more great IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.